Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I hope you're doing well. Hope you're having a wonderful day. And then I'll say even more magical because today I'm super excited. I've been going through a lot of tests. We have just a few left and I'm working hard on my portfolio because I've put on a lot of universities, so I have a lot of stuff to follow and do. So that is kind of the reason why the videos are pre-recorded. University applications are going well, but because I have so many portfolios I need to set up and things to finish for the portfolios, it's getting really crowded. But it's super, super enjoyable because I have like 4 hours on Friday, for example, to make art, only art, which is super cool. But yeah, welcome to another The Warning Tuesday. So I'm cutting into the schedule of the warning I've set up just to put in Animosity, the newest webtoon kind of version of the song. I actually haven't heard Animosity because I had so many things to do, so I didn't have time to actually listen to it, as well as Z. I did listen to the main song of the album, but I didn't listen to Animosity. So the other videos will come along next week and everything, like weeks. Every week we'll have the new one. But yeah, I'm checking out Animosity for the very first time, and it's the webtoon, so I'm super excited. I don't know what to expect. Collaboration.
I've already collapsed, so I'll just drown my sorrows in a non-existent world.
Wow, it's like eyes.
Don't know what is worse, the utter waste of time will be eroding of my mind. Alive means to be dead, a bullet to the head. The guilt faded away, the anger has subsided, yet a shadow still remains. I always give too much, it was never enough. Get dressed in black as mourn again. Thank you.
Okay, I love how this just flows by, but has so many changes in the actual flow of the music that is crazy. Like, oh, wow, like look at this.
The guilt faded away, the anger has subsided.
We completely cut off like an instrument and it's so like you can so much hear it, but like it feels like a completely different music style, for example, for me. But it's just like a cutting of an instrument.
The anger has subsided, yet a shadow still remains.
The art style is gorgeous, by the way. And this looks so pretty. Like, oh, wow, I love it. I love the roughness of it too. Like, it adds to the actual version of the song and everything. It all just flows through so well. Like, all these eyes. I think of them as eyes or people. They could be people all connected to each other or locked up or something. Trapped. Or this is like a cage, a trap. So cool.
Worse, the utter waste of time will be.
I love how the drums are not actually starting
mind.
It. Really cool.
Alive means to be dead. A bullet to the head.
The intensity is so cool.
Has subsided, yet a shadow still remains. I always give too much, it was never enough. Get dressed in black as mourn again. Fake funerals for all my friends, cause I can't let it go. No, I won't let it go.
I love the guitar part here. It sounds so good. And the drums just, it's something completely new and different. I haven't heard of them play yet. So this is really cool. But, oh god, the story's so insane. It's like she's been controlled by a demon and so has to kill all those who do something wrong, like rob, try to kill, and all these. Is that it? Okay, wow. This is so cool. First of all, I don't get if the person is on the, she's probably on the bad side, right? They were in a feud here, especially. And he now likes her because she saved him. They're about to fight. Sorry, trying to understand what the heck's going on. Oh, this is so cool though, like the art style. I love this roughness, kind of dripping. It's kind of like like how nothing's perfect in a way, but it is. It's so cool. It just adds so much. I love how she has like the Grim Reaper's scythe or something. She has to be on the bot side, right? I love this transition. This is so cool. Obviously, music is killer. But what I love is that transition to them, and they look so cool, and the actual animation is so flawless when they play too. It's so much fun. My friends, 'cause I can't let it go. No, I won't let it go. It's killing me again. I replay it in my head when I'm alone. I hope that you're alone now. It's not me, it's you. The one who never got a clue, drowning your guilt. If karma doesn't hit you, then I will. Mayday,
that was so cool.
Mayday,
this ship is going
down.
Oh, they say mayday.
Lost inside my thoughts again. Living hollow to pretend. Mayday, mayday, this ship is going down. Bury the truth of the law you created. Bury yourself and remember me when you're alone. Mayday, mayday, this ship is going down.
I love the slight sound you can hear of her, like, kind of weapon and her transforming. This is so cool. She's rebelling against the actual demons inside her. This is so cool.
Oh my god. That was amazing. I love it. I love it. The animation's flawless. Super cool. Just insane. I love the rebellion at the end. Clear to say that the music is gorgeous. I even love this. This part's kind of like the heavens above where you're like trying to reach the person who harmed you up there. This is so, so cool. So cool. I love the difference here. Because the song also kind of swifts and changes. I love this. This is so cool. I don't know the reason why they want to be represented here in this scene. Like, slowly the actual characters fading. And I would actually want to know why the actual band is included in the story. Is there a point that they just want to have their figures in the story to do something to remind them that, you know, we're telling you this story, or there's something going on and we're in it and it's part of this world, and that's why they put the actual band in the story to make it like, you know, this story could happen in the real world or something. Maybe that's it. But then, like, they fade and it's like, The one who never got a clue, Johnny, your ghost. If karma doesn't hit too bad, I will. Mayday, mayday. I love that we're using more of the discs as well in this song. It's so cool. It just adds a bit of a different character to it. And it's so, so cool and fun. Bury the truth, not the lie. I love how Danny's voice is kind of like an instrument as well that kind of holds when the music changes. Like here, she holds her note and the music actually changes and adds something different. It's so flawlessly made. Like, there's so much complexity in terms of changing the sound, the music, the rhythm, the tempo. And it all happens so flawlessly because they either just remove an instrument or add a voice longer, or just prolong something else to cut something else, and then it's not a scene, but then you realize that there's a huge change in the actual music. It's so cool. Like, it's so interesting. Definitely gonna be one of the songs I'm gonna watch and listen to a lot. I also love how nice and flawless this animation is. The figures are so cool. Also, look at I love the flip of the hair. They are just like, I like how they are in there, and I like the building representation. It reminds me of 21st Century Blood. Them on the roof with the buildings and everything and all that setup. It's kind of like this, but this is animated. They look so cool. They look so insane and epic. It's so much fun to listen to and enjoy. I just loved it. First impressions were the best. I just had a blast. This was so cool. Like, the music is insane. The animation was insane. I love how, like, the art style of the actual artist, Grim Reaper is the artist's name. Super cool, like, job. Like, I love also the perspectives they have. Like, look at this. This is just so interesting. Like, the alley. It's not like and you see it like this. You see it from above, which is super fun. I love the different angles. It just makes it so interesting. I also love the half realistic kind of view of the city, because the buildings and stuff are actually kind of buildings. You know, it's like drawn and animated, like the characters. It just adds so much more creativity to it. I love, like, the details like this. It's all these things that just add something like this. It's the reflection on the glasses. It's just so cool. It's so insane. Like, look at these. Are the three creatures, by the way, the three girls, are they? No, I won't let it go.
They are. That's Danny.
No, I won't let it.
That's Ali. And that's Pat. Oh, this is so cool. Wow. It's like they are the monsters destroying the city. Oh, this is so cool. The more you watch it, the more details you find, and it's so insane and so cool. Go watch it again and tell me what new did you actually find watching it again, because it's so crazy. There's so many details and things. It's insane. Would love to know the actual meaning of the song if you guys have it. I know that the warning opens up the meaning of the song a lot, so that's why I kind of ran with trying to give my own meaning. So I want to know your meaning, and I want to know if there's an actual meaning as well. So many meanings. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to like, subscribe, click the bell for notifications. Albert over here will be sending you, and I'll see you guys next time in my next commentary. Bye bye for now.